Hello, dear people, big and small. This is Faye TV with your crazy auntie Frida. And last year around that time, I did the Icelandic Yule Lads in German. So I thought it's maybe time to do them in English so almost everybody can understand what I want to explain. This is a typical Icelandic Christmas tradition. I have not seen it in any other country. And actually, when I started learning Icelandic, my friends and I made fun of this. Like, such a small country needs 13 Santa Clauses. No, 12. Okay, but 13 is my lucky number. And the mother of the Santa Clauses is also important. So, yes, there are more than 12 figurines. And it's a big family, yes, and they start coming on the 12th of December, like the night when between the 11th and the 12th, one per day, and every Icelandic child knows that, even though I've heard some funny stories that the children can't tell them apart unless they have a certain trademark that they like people in the costume wear, so, or unless you say in a costume which Santa Claus, which Yule troll you are. In modern times they look more like Santa Clauses, but they are intended like Yule trolls. So today's special guest is called Stekkjastur. And legend has it that he has like either a leg missing or a leg very stiff, and he goes into the sheep stables to suck on the udder of the female sheep. I could theoretically imagine more cleanly and nice ways to get food, but when I think of this guy, I always think of the historical idea that people with disabilities were like considered poor or considered outside society. And I have written some papers and pondered some things that many legendary creatures are actually based on actual disabled people who were just not fitting into the society and were then made into a legend. I even suspect that the hobbits are like based on some quite original people who were a little bit, let's say, not mainstream. I don't know. I can't prove it, but it is an idea to think about. So actually, my wish concerning Stekkjastur and all odd people in Christmas time is let's give each other some patience to get to know each other and to also enjoy good food together. Really see food as a community so nobody has to sneak anywhere and get food in some unhygienic ways. So, I wish for a Christmas time of togetherness, and I wish for your comments on my pictures and things that you want to know about Iceland and Icelandic culture. Bye! See you at the next Yule Lad tomorrow!